That's strong. Coffee and Coke mixture. Not for the faint of heart. Anyway, I am your brother L, welcoming you to podcast number 245 of I'm For Real, Yes It's True.com. Today is June 4th, 2023, and the name of today's episode is Didn't See That Coming. All right, so I want to welcome those of you who are new here. Hang out. We get in and out in 10 minutes. We punch the point. Excuse me. We have a good time doing it, and we end up with scripture that authenticates the story that we're trying to tell. And we also, especially on this new website, we have navigate through it. It's really easy to get through, and we have these wonderful, wonderful subscription gifts that we'd love to put into your hands free of charge. All you need to do is let us have your contact information, and we'll get it sent out to you. And also, one of the things we do quite a bit around here is we drink quite a bit of coffee. You don't have to mix yours with Coke. You can drink it straight or any way you like. I'm going to take one more sip, and we're going to dive into today's story before I chew up all of our time yapping. All right? Man, that is a strong mixture this time. Okay, let's dive into the story. A brother in a recent Bible study made a comment that we are all horribly flawed and in desperate need of a savior. Honestly, I don't know how God continues to put up with us over and over again. If it were me, I'd give a person 3 strikes. And if he continued to blow it, well, they're on their own. I say that because I believe that many of us, knowing how long-suffering God is, take advantage of his mercifulness. Too many of us speak like angels and live like demons. Until their sins are made public. Then they make us all look like phony hypocrites. I hate when a well-known evangelist or Bible expositor gets busted with prostitutes or trying to score coke. It brings into question, in a lot of people's minds, just how real and devoted are the rest of us. Well, are we just showing out for the cameras? Or do we really live like we love Jesus when no one is looking? Okay, that was the letter. First off, I'm glad this brother isn't God, because 3 strikes just ain't enough, at least not for my life. We serve a God of second chances and more, who is patient and long-suffering. Also, good people are going to think what they want to think. You'll never be able to convince anybody that you are the real deal. All right? All we can do is love the Lord with all our heart, soul, and mind, and try to live out a life that gives him honor. Amen? It doesn't matter who you are, you're going to fall, because we're wrapped in this flesh, and there is no perfection on this side of eternity. All right, so deal with that hard reality. Time to take a quick sip, and then we're gonna finish up with the next page. So I'm gonna take a quick sip of my coffee. I'm gonna clear my throat. You can do the same, and then we'll finish up here. Forgive me, I got a lot of notes, and I just wanna stay on point. I'm not ignoring you. I know you're there, and I appreciate you. But I just want to stay on point here. Now it's time to take a quick sip and we'll finish up. Ooh-wee! That's a strong one this week, folks. Okay, now what the Bible says. 2 Peter 3:8-9 reads, and I normally read from the NIV. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. Instead, he is patient with you, not wanting anyone should perish, but everyone to come to repentance. Amen. Ephesians 2:4-5 reads, he is rich in mercy, but because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. Amen and amen. And I'm going to leave it right there for this week, good people. Thank God that he is long-suffering and merciful. And just want you to know, I'm your brother L. I'm not your pastor, but I love you, and I want to hang out in heaven with you. We're going to have a good time. If it's God's will, I'll see you back here again next week. Don't forget your coffee. And go out this week and do something good for someone else. Someone that you don't even know and that you got no stake in. All right? I guarantee you that the good God we serve is going to bless you for it. Amen? Amen. Navigate through the website. You'll see a place to leave comments if you wish. Request some of these wonderful subscription gifts that we have. Not going to cost you one red dime, and I promise you that. Just leave us your contact information, a place to send it to you. If you want completely, and totally obligation-free, you can leave a donation. We take everything that we take in, and we send it back to community partners that we've partnered up with that work with the homeless population. All right? So that's where your dollars are going to. Okay. I'm your brother, L, and I love you, and I'm hoping to see you again next week. Hope I haven't forgotten anything. I was speaking a little fast this week. That's the effects of the coffee. God bless you. We'll see you again soon. Amen. Amen. Ooh. It's amazing that this stuff doesn't keep me up at night.